Hello, everyone. I will be telling you more stuff about motion, okay? So now I'm going to go on some equations of motion, and today is focusing on motion along a straight line at a constant acceleration, okay? So uniform acceleration. And these four formulas that you see here on the screen, they are actually going to be quite important, okay? So they're going to be quite useful for all the exercises that you're going to do now, and or from now on, and I'm going to tell you more or less what these symbols mean, okay? So V stands for velocity, okay, final velocity, and U stands for initial velocity. For V can be the velocity at any time as well, any given time. A stands for acceleration, and T stands for the time taken, okay? Now, I have S. S is going to be for the displacement, okay, how much I moved. So I have, again, U, V, and T, so I told you what these guys are. Again, S, so, and then again, U and V. So you already know all the things that they are there. So for example, I can say velocity equals initial velocity plus acceleration times the time that this acceleration is happening. Space or distance moved is going to be the average velocity times the time, so U plus V divided by 2 times the time. It can be as well, the distance moved, it can be initial velocity times the time plus 1/2 of acceleration times the time squared, or I can say that the times velocity squared equals initial velocity squared plus 2 times acceleration times the distance moved, okay? Now, these equations, they are given to you in the exams. However, you may be asked to derive them, okay? So if you want to derive them, follow the steps that I have in here. And if I have time, after I do all these videos for my classes, I will be as well making videos about step-by-step that they're deriving these formulas. But if you follow these steps, you will be able to do it by yourself, okay? So if you want to derive the first formula, so this one in here, you really just need to rearrange the general acceleration formula. Remember that acceleration is going to be equal to the final minus the initial velocity divided by time. So this is purely rearranging a formula, okay? If you want to get the second formula, you use the general velocity formula and the average velocity formula for constant acceleration. So you know that velocity equals distance over time, so the distance is going to be the velocity times the time. Now, if my velocity is not always the same, I need to do the average, the mean velocity. And to take a mean of a value, it's just adding up the two values that I have, initial and final, and divide them by 2. So that's done, okay? I think I told you, you may be asked to derive them in the exams. Sometimes they give you some clues on how you can do it, but they may not, okay? So it's good to know how we do it. Next one. For this third formula, you need to combine the equations 1 and 2 and eliminate V, okay? So combine these two equations. You can substitute this V here as U plus AT, and then you just, you know, carry on and you will see UT plus 1/2, there we go, of AT squared, okay? So give it a go and try it. And then for the last formula, there are many ways to do it, okay? But one way is to do acceleration times the speed, oh my god, that S is for the distance traveled, okay? So the other way of doing is to do the acceleration times the distance traveled and combine the equations 1 and 2 again to eliminate the time, okay? So again, you can do this in function of time, or you can do A times S, okay? And you will get to the fourth formula. I think that you will be fine to get any of the formulas. The fourth one may take you a little bit longer, but if you give it a go, you will see that you get to that answer, okay? So that's how to derive them. Now, when I have a graph, so this is, oopsie, sorry, I just wanted to move this away. When I have a velocity time graph, I can calculate displacement very easily, okay? So the displacement is going to be the area under the line of a velocity time graph, okay? So I can have two types of velocity time graphs. I can have with constant acceleration or changing acceleration, okay? If my acceleration is constant, can be and the constant number of zero. So this is the type of graph that I have. I have a constant speed because my acceleration is zero. I may also have a constant acceleration that is different to zero. And this is an example, okay? So I always have the same gradient in a speed-time graph, but my acceleration has a number. So my velocity is not constant. I am just either accelerating or decelerating. Finally, for changing acceleration, my graph is going to look like this, like a curve, okay? And that's going to be a little bit harder to calculate the displacement, okay? But this is how we do it. So to get the areas, if it's a constant acceleration, really, you get a rectangle or a square, right? So the area is the height times the base, which is simply the speed times the time, okay? If you want for constant acceleration different to zero, then the area is going to be the average height times the base, okay? So you can decide to do it as a triangle or a trapezium. So you can do a triangle and add the area of the triangle times the area of this rectangle in here. So I can make two different shapes and then add the two areas together. Or you can simply do the area of a trapezium, okay? Here, for example, you can do one half of u plus v and everything times t, okay? And this would be the average height times the base. Now, if I have a changing acceleration, then it's going to be a little bit different, okay? It may be more difficult. We will not give you a formula. We are not going to give you the equation of the line, so you cannot do the integral. So what you need to do is you need to divide the area under the curve by tiny spaces, okay? Tiny rectangles. And then you calculate the area in each of the rectangles, okay? So you go ahead and you calculate the area. And it will more or less give you, because sometimes when you do like this, for example, this is going to be taken away from this side, so it's fine. And this will give you the displacement, okay? So for a changing acceleration, what you need to do is the sum of the areas of each strip, okay, each rectangle. And each rectangle is going to be of a difference of t to t plus tiny delta t, okay? So a tiny amount of time, all right? So I hope it made sense. Yeah, that's the end of the lesson. So I hope it made sense. And if you have any questions, do let me know either directly or then just drop me a message on the videos, okay? And that's all for today, so I am going to go, and I don't remember what I'm going to do next, but you will see. Bye!